गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान। आई वेलकम यू इन टूडेज सेगमेंट। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेगमेंट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। देर आर द थ्री इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन स्टूडेंट। फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन इज वी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी। सेकेंड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन इज एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वेयर। थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन इज 2as इज इक्वल टू वी स्केयर माइनस यू स्केयर। सो देर आर द थ्री इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन इफ यू नो अबाउट द टू फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, मीन्स इफ यू नो अबाउट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द टू फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, देन वी कैन ईजीली गेट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द थर्ड और फोर्थ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी मैग्नीट्यूड स्टूडेंट। सो इट इज़ द बेनिफिट ऑफ द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। नाउ हाउ डू वी गेट द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन? इन योर बुक इट इज गिवन डैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन वी कैन ड्राइव द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। लाइक द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन डैट इज वी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी। And this equation we can get with the help of velocity time relation. Now what we do in that, first we will draw the graph, and in this graph we will consider one automobile transport that is moving with uniform acceleration, but that particular automobile transport have initial velocity other than zero. Like in this I have drawn one graph, this is y axis, this is x axis. X axis represent the time and y axis represent the velocity. Now in this student, this y axis is representing the velocity, and in this student the velocity is starting from other than zero velocity, means velocity is not starting from zero or from the origin, it is starting from other than zero. So we can say that in this we will consider an automobile transport that is moving with other than zero velocity, and its initial velocity is other than zero and u is unequal to zero. So from here it is starting, from this A point, and it reaches to B point, means its final velocity will be on this E point. This is its final velocity. So there are two velocity we will get in this. This is initial velocity and this is final velocity. Now in this we will draw one parallel line parallel to the time axis. Here we will also draw the parallel line. Now from here we will draw this line to this C point, B to C. Now with the help of this we will know that the acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time taken. Now in this we will write that change in velocity can be indicated with the help of this graph. This BD can show the change in velocity, because this B is representing final velocity and this D is representing initial velocity, and BD upon AD, and AD is indicating the time. This time is indicating, and we can also show it BD is equal up BD is upon OC. So this line on x-axis OC, it is OC. So OC is indicating the time. Now BD, what is the meaning of BD here? BD means here V minus U. BD is here is equal to V minus U. And this OC is here OC is here equal to tie. So BD is equal to V minus U and OC is equal to tie. So the equation that we will get here, it is VA is equal to V minus U upon T. Is the same formula we will get in this. Now we can also get another formula in this, that is V minus U is equal to AT. Now we will inbox it. So this is the first equation of the motion, and this equation of the motion indicates the relation in between velocity and time. So with the help of the first equation of motion, we can know about the three quantities. First is velocity, second is initial velocity, third is acceleration, and with the acceleration we also know about the time. So it is the first equation of the motion, student. Now we come on the second equation of motion. So student, now we will derive the second equation of motion, and it is position time relation. Means in this we will use the same graph that we have drawn in the first equation of motion, and in this we will consider the same condition, student, in which an object is moving with uniform acceleration, and in this also the acceleration is uniform, and with this the initial velocity is not zero. Means the object is starting its velocity from here, from this point, and it is its initial velocity. So for this we will use here the mathematics, and in the geometry you have read about the trapezium. So in this we will take the trapezium, area of the trapezium. This is the trapezium, student, this, and this trapezium covers the two shapes. First is rectangle, second is triangle, student. Now this area of trapezium is indicating OABC. So this is OABC. So this particular area is known as trapezium. Now when we get the area of the trapezium, then what we do, we add area of rectangle into area of triangle. Means we do the adding of the area of rectangle and area of triangle, adding we do in this. So in this, area of rectangle is OADC. What is it? It is OADC, means this area. This area is indicating area of rectangle. And area of triangle, in this the area of triangle that we will take is, it is this ABD, this. Now the formula that we use to get the area of rectangle, what is it, student? Length into breadth. So here we also take the length into breadth. OA, it is the length, and it is the breadth, OA, this OA, and OC, it is the length, OC. So this we will write here, OA into OC. Next is half AD. In this, half AD, AD is here, this base, BD is here, height, this. So this we will write here, AD into BD. Now what we will do, we will put all the physical quantities in the place of this OA. OA is indicating initial velocity, so we write here initial velocity as U. OC is indicating time, OC is indicating time taken, so we will write here T. So it becomes UT plus दिस हाफ ई विल राइट हियर आफ्टर हाफ ए डी, ए डी इज दिस, दिस इज ए डी एंड ए डी इज इंडिकेटिंग द टाइम, टाइम टेकन बिकॉज इट इज पैरेलल टू ओ सी, सो इट इज टेलिंग अबाउट द टाइम, अबाउट द टाइम इट इज टेलिंग, सो वी विल पुट इट हेयर टी ए डी एंड बी डी इन अवर फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन वी हैव डन द बी डी ना, वट इज बी डी, बी डी इज इक्वल टू वी माइनस यू, वी माइनस यू एंड इट इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू ए टी, वट इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन वी माइनस यू इज इक्वल टू ए टी, सो दिस बी डी also equal to AT. So we will write here in the place of BD we write AT. Acceleration into time AT. Now when we do the calculation here the equation of motion that we will get it is S is equal to UT plus half AT square and it is known as second equation of motion and with the help of this we can know about the distance, initial velocity, time and acceleration. So it is about the second equation of motion student and with the help of this we can derive the second equation of motion means with the help of the graphical representation and in this we use the same graph as we have taken in the first equation of motion. So now we come on the third equation of motion student, third equation of motion. So in third equation of motion student we will consider the same graph like we have taken in the second and the first equation of motion. In this we will take the same graph. Now in this what happened we will take use the same formula. S is equal to area of trapezium, area of trapezium. But now we will take common in this and by taking the common we will get another formula in this and it will be OA plus BC into OC upon 2, this we will get. Now in this OA we will put, OA is indicating U, U means initial velocity, so we will write here initial velocity. BC, BC is indicating BC, this is the BC student, BC and BC is indicating final velocity, so we will write here final velocity V and OC is indicating time, so we will write here time T. Now what we will do, we will use the formula of T here that we will get with the help of first equation of motion. And what is the first equation of motion student? V is equal to, means V is equal to this V, means this T is equal to V minus U upon A, V minus U upon A. So this we will put here. And what is it? It will be U plus V, V minus U is upon 2a, 2a and the equation of motion that we will get here it will be s is equal to v square minus u square upon 2a and in the last we will get 2as is equal to v square minus u square and it is the third equation of motion. 2as is equal to v square minus u square and it is known as third equation of motion and with the help of third equation of motion we can know about the relation in between position and time with the help of graphical representation. And we can also know about the four quantities like final velocity, initial velocity, distance and acceleration. So it is about the equation of motion, student. Now you will try to understand it and you will write it in your notebook. Thank you very much and have a pleasant day.